Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome once again to FanCode DCC X10 Rapid Fire Division 1, match number 19. We are live from the 7th Stadium, and as you can see, the two teams are IGM and DCC Starlets. Well, what a game we have on our hands. Two top sides are going to take it on against each other.
So the news from the center is DCC Starlet captain Ronak Panoli has won the toss and they have elected to bat first.
That was Mudassir Ali along with the two captains and the most handsome man, Mr. Shiju Sam, the match referee. Quickly looking at the lineups for the two sides, DCC Starlets. The captain Ronak Panoli, Punya Mehra, Dhruv Parashar, Vansh Kumar, Ahan Fernandez, Izan Khan, Aman Ali, Aditya Shetty, Zain Hamid, Jayaditya Malik and Shamim Ali. And to talk about the IGM, I've got my partner in crime in the comm box. It's Kes Farooq. Kes, good evening and welcome.
Good evening everybody. Yeah, IGM, a very strong side. Asif Khan, Sandeep Singh, Taimur Bhatti, Taukeer Riyasat, Vishnu, Sukumaran, Harry Barwal, Yasir Kaleem, the captain and wicketkeeper, Hazrat Luqman, Zahid Muhammad, Hamid Khan and Danish Qureshi.
So it's match number 19, IGM versus DCC Starlets. So the IGM setup looks like a strong setup. They've got some big superstars of the domestic circuit and also some international players. Asif Khan right at the front. And you can see Hamid in the white cap. He's an explosive opening batter. Vishnu Sukumaran, he too is definitely in the scheme of things for UAE cricket. While the two openers out in the middle, I think this is a very good decision. You can see Ronak Panoli, that's an obvious choice. Yeah. But then Ahan Fernandez, guess. Here we go. Ball number one. Short and wide, and Ronak Panoli. Well, that is bread and butter for this man who's so immensely talented. Gets off the mark with a four. I think his guard is down against Ronak Panoli. You can't be bowling that first ball to somebody like Ronak Panoli. That's much better, closer to the stump. But the result is going to be the same.
Someone like Ronak, and we know he flashes hard. There's no protection on that boundary.
Slashes again. I don't understand this field setting. The third is inside the 30-yard circle. Beautiful hit. This time it's from along the carpet, right from the middle of the bat. No edges involved. And that's gone racing away towards the boundary for four.
Oh, Ronak's hit that over the mid-wicket fielder. Didn't time it that well. But it's still gone over that mid-wicket boundary for another four.
I like the balance. Goes big. Again, takes the top edge. The pull was on. Just couldn't middle it. But never mind, because Ronak Panoli has got four runs for it.
And perform much better than what he's been doing. As Ronak's played that straight over the fielder for another boundary. And who best to do it than the captain himself? Oh, Ronak's hit that straight. And it's gone over the fielder. That's going to run away for another four. Ronak's only dealing in boundaries at the moment. He's got DCC off to a flyer. 41 on the board now.
For Ronak Panoli against Zahid. Short ball. That's a poor delivery. That will find the fielder though. So it is an effective delivery because he's got that field in place for that ball. And Zahid strikes. Ronak Panoli's entertaining innings comes to an end. And he gets a wicket. Make that two now immediately. As soon as he's come into the attack, a big wicket falls. Punya Mehra.
And that's been swept towards that short fine leg area. There's no cover there. And Dhruv gets off the mark with a boundary.
Also, part of the ICC umpires. That's hit nicely from Ahan Fernandez. Has it got the distance? No, it hasn't. It was high up in the air. And Hamid, the fielder, does well to take it.
Now it's up to Aditya Shetty and Dhruv.
Slower played over extra cover. That's a good shot. Deserves four runs and will get four runs. Nicely played.
They have that bowling lineup where they can defend 98 to 100 odd runs.
Well, if the first shot was good, this was even better from Aditya Shetty. Inside out against Harry Barwal. Couldn't connect it too well, but he's moved on to 16 as DCC Starlets breach the 71 run mark. Big hit in the air. Easy. Easy as it gets. Another wicket for Harry Barwal. And Dhruv Parashar, looking to score big, has to walk back. Shammi Malli, the new man. First ball comes in. First ball goes out. It's straight down. Aditya Shetty continues the onslaught.
Straight over the bowler's head for a couple of bounces. 75 for... flick of the wrist this time. It was on the leg stump.
Short ball missed. Well, that's given. Edged and taken. I thought it missed the bat. Expect a lot from the others. He's got bat to ball finally. That's gone towards the cover sweeper. Hamid will cut that off. And it will only be a single. Jayaditya Malik was run out on that last ball, trying to take the second run. So one run will be added to the total. And Taimur Bhatti scores. Stats will read 2 for 2.
Just to remind, DC Starlets has won the toss and they have elected to bat first. And talking about the batting, Ronak Panoli, the captain, once again among the runs, 34 to his name of just 13 deliveries. Ahan Fernandez struggles, continues 9 runs off 11 deliveries. Punya, just a single to his name. Dhruv, 7. But this 30 odd runs definitely will make the difference, I believe. Aditya Shetty of just 16 balls. Shamim and Aman, without troubling the scorers, went back to the pavilion. Jayaditya scored just a run and got run out on the last delivery of the innings. And talking about the bowling card, it will be Shoaib.
Yes, 6 bowlers used. Pick of the bowlers, Harry Barwal getting 3 wickets in his 2 overs, giving away 17 runs. 2 wickets for Taimur Bhatti. He too was exceptional. Look at that economy for Taimur. In 2 overs, gave away just 2 runs and took 2 wickets as well.
Good evening and once again, welcome back to all the viewers from Sevens Cricket Stadium. It's a match number 19 between IGM and DCC Starlets. For the chase, IGM need 87 runs to win this match.
It was a below par batting performance from the DCC Starlets. I feel they're going to think they're about 15 to 20 short, depending on the start they got.
Here we go. Shamim will be bowling the first delivery to Asif Lala. A decent start, I would say, but a harsh call.
And that's been powered by Asif Khan over that long gone mid-wicket area for a maximum. That's very predictable bowling from Shamim. He's operating with a long on and a deep mid-wicket. Oh, that's been hit towards that vacant third man area for another 4. Lucky. And all he had to do is just put his bat towards it. I think he was trying to evade the ball rather than hit it towards third man, but he gets a boundary nonetheless. And again, that's been uppercut over that third man fielder. Another boundary for Asif Khan. This is very poor bowling from Shamim. Has been powered by Asif Khan towards the mid-wicket region. The fielder had no chance of stopping that. That's another boundary to Asif. No. And Asif's hit that again over that mid-wicket, long or mid-on fielder for another boundary. Asif's only dealing in boundaries at the moment.
To open his account. And talking about opening his account, he opens with a boundary. Played towards deep square leg. A poor delivery dispatched by Hamid Khan. 277 in this tournament, Hamid Khan. Big heave towards the mid-wicket, and it's a maximum, first maximum from the blade of Hamid Khan, a flighted delivery sent over the mid-wicket.
And they were neck and neck before the start of this over. They were both at 30-odd as Hamid Khan's hit that again between the deep mid-wicket and long on fielder for another boundary.
On crease, Hamid Khan batting on 14 of just 5 deliveries. Once again, trying to play towards the mid-wicket, a top edge, and a well-judged catch taken by Malik.
I feel they need to get either one of these batsmen very, very early in the next over or so. As Aditya Shetty is appealed and he's been given a big wicket. Come at the hour, come at the man.
Comes in Ronak, stepping down the plate towards mid-wicket. Fielder coming underneath. A brilliant catch taken by Aditya Shetty. What a day this lad is having.
Yeah, they're not going to be concerned too much about this. As Vishnu's played that towards the deep mid-wicket area, he's deposited it over the fielder for a maximum.
Leading the chart of bowling. Clean ball, a googly by Aditya Shetty. Walks back Sandeep Singh Sandy. Brilliant delivery. Wild swing by Sandeep Singh Sandy.
You know, when the tournament started, we had seen some stats as Dhruv Parashar comes in to bowl and Taukeer's played that towards the extra cover region for a boundary. That's a poor ball first up. Oh, that missed everybody. And very, very poor keeping from Vansh Kumar. He can't, the Dream cannot afford these extra runs and he's just conceded 4 byes. The captain will not be happy about that one. Zain Hamid has been given the responsibility to finish off the game. And Taukeer has hit that over the long on fielder for a boundary and that's the end of the game. Zain's stint at the crease has only lasted 1 ball as IGM have convincingly beaten DCC Starlets by 6 wickets. Yes, it was a good performance overall. Some things to work on for the management and coaching staff of DCC Starlets as we have a look at the IGM batting card. Asif Lala, 30 of 14 deliveries. He was only dealing in boundaries. Hamid Khan, 14 of 6 deliveries. Yasir Kaleem fell cheaply to a brilliantly bowled spell by Aditya Shetty. So did Sandeep Singh. Vishnu and Taukeer with 10 and 22 respectively cleaned up and finished off the innings and ensured victory for IGM. The bowling card for DCC Starlets, Shamim Ali, no wicket for 18 of his 1 over. Izan Khan, no wicket for 12 of his 1 over. Ronak Panoli, touch expensive, but he got 2 wickets. Aditya Shetty, the bowler of the day, 2 overs, 8 for 2. Dhruv Parashar went for 9 of his solitary over. Jaiditya Malik went for 10 of his 1 over. And Zain Hamid only bowled the 1 over for 4 runs.
Talking about the match summary, Ronak Panoli, 34 to his name. Aditya Shetty, quick 30. Ahan Fernandez, 9. They managed 86 of 10 overs. IGM in reply made 89 for the loss of 4 wickets. Courtesy to Asif Khan's brilliant 30. Taukeer Riaza, 22, unbeaten. And Hamid Khan, 14 at the end. IGM winning the match by 6 wickets.